Rich Eisen, Deion Sanders, Steve Mariucci, LaDainian Tomlinson, and also Michael Irvin with the highlights of tonight. Adrian Peterson breaking the huddle, trying to get to 6 wins in week number 8. Josh Freeman coming off of a tough home loss against the Saints, already up 3-0. Hit as he throws, nice grab by Vincent Jackson, his only grab of the first half.
Just talked to Vincent Jackson. I told him I love the way they're using him going close the middle of the football field. What a play.
Four Vikings around him. He comes down with it near the red zone, and then play action. Eric Loring, everybody, out of the backfield.
Nice play action fake to Doug Martin and slip the fullback out in the flat. Easy touchdown for Josh.
10-0, 48-yard drive right there. It's 13-0 in the second quarter now. Christian Ponder needed to get something going, and he throws that bubble screen to Percy Harvin.
They blocked that so well, body on body, and that's the man to get the ball to.
32 yards later, 3 plays later, 3rd and 6 from the red zone. Why not try Harvin again?
Boy, right here, you see what a play. Bam, by Percy Harvin. You wonder why he's one of the best in the league, because he can make those kinds of adjustments after coming out of the backfield.
13-7 is your score, and the Vikings get the ball back and are moving down the field, and that's when the game essentially turns. Of all people, LT, it's Adrian Peterson, who seemingly had that fumbleitis problem taken care of.
Yeah, he's trying to make a play right here. Great play by Rondae Barber coming in, stripping the ball.
First fumble loss since week 16 of 2010, and the Bucs turn that one into points. Josh Freeman flips this one to the corner of the end zone. Mike Williams toe tap, and that is a touchdown.
Good game by Mike Williams.
10 points off of 2 Minnesota turnovers. It's 20-10 Tampa at the half. That was essentially ruled by Doug Martin. He had 103 rushing yards in the first half, first 100-yard rushing game of his rookie career, and then the third quarter, different quarter, same old story. Here comes Doug Martin on the screen, and he is out the gate.
Yeah, this is blocked beautifully, too. You get the lineman out in front, and Doug Martin is a fast guy from Boise State. Nobody's going to catch this guy. Touchdown, Bucs.
That technically is a touchdown pass for Josh Freeman, since Martin did most of it, but that gave Freeman 3 straight games with 3 touchdowns. First Buck quarterback ever to do that. But here comes Adrian Peterson.
That burst is back. Look at that speed when he get in the open field. He's gone, guys. Nobody's going to catch him.
64 yards,
that's the sign of a great back. They're able to make one guy miss.
And Jerome Simpson with the big block. This is not a block in the back. It's on the side. Good job by the refs to not flag him for it. That is a legal block. It is a 30-17 game. And that's when Josh Freeman trying to get Vincent Jackson incomplete. And that is when things began getting going on the trenches with Jared Allen and Donald Penn playing the feud.
Boy.
MMA.
Oh, here comes the helmet.
Oh.
Right off.
Give him a knee.
Hey.
And Allen is bleeding from the nose, and he's, you don't poke the beast
you
like that.
You don't mess with the rhinestone cowboy.
Offsetting penalties.
Watch what happens the next play.
There he comes. He ropes him up some. Josh Freeman, first time on the night that Freeman was sacked.
This place went berserk.
It went nuts, coach.
But would the offense be able to match the intensity and rise to the occasion? The answer was no, because Josh Freeman got the ball back and put together a big-time, big boy, crowd-quieting, closeout drive, converting to Mike Williams on 3rd and 10. Big-time drive. 16 plays, took over 9 minutes. And how many third downs were converted on that?
5 third downs. 5 third downs on that drive.
Including Doug Martin with the cherry on top. Capper on a 3rd and 1, puts it across the goal line. Leslie Frazier watched the Bucs come in and boat race the Minnesota Vikings by the final score of 36-17.